Howdy, I'm Professor Curtis of Aspire Mountain Academy here with more statistics homework help. Today, we're going to learn how to find the mean of a frequency distribution. Here's our problem statement. Find the mean of the data summarized in the given frequency distribution. Compare the computed mean to the actual mean of 58.2 degrees. So we have a table here listing temperatures and frequency counts. So let's go ahead and click this icon to the right. We're going to open this in StatCrunch, and let's just move our table over here a little bit. There, now that we've resized our window, we can see everything. So we have our data here in StatCrunch, but notice these are frequency counts, and the way we can do this really easy in StatCrunch requires us to have midpoints for each of the classes. What we have listed here are actually the lower and upper class limits for each of our bins. So that's not going to help us with the StatCrunch. So we have to actually calculate out here in another column what the actual frequency midpoints are going to be. So here's my calculator. I'm just going to get the average of my upper and lower class limits for that first class there. So 44 plus 40, 84 divided by 2, 42. So my first midpoint is 42. I'm going to do it again. The next class, so put that out, 49. Plus 45 divided by 2, 47. Now, if you notice, 47 is 5 more than 42, and that's because 45, or the lower limit for the second class, is 5 more than 40, which is the lower limit for the first class. Or you can compare the upper limits. You can see they're also separated by 5. So I can just go ahead and just add 5 to each one of these midpoints here to get the rest for my table. If you want, you could actually calculate the averages like we were doing with the first two bins, but you'll come out with these numbers here. And now we're ready to find the mean of the frequency distribution. StatCrunch makes this super easy. You don't have to use that obnoxious formula that's in your textbook. So now that we've got the midpoints and we've got the frequency counts, let's go up to Stat. I'm going to click on Calculators and then go down here to the bottom where it says Custom. Values are going to be the midpoints that we just calculated. So I'm going to select that column. Weights are the frequency counts. So I select that column. Then I just hit Compute. And voila, look here, the mean value, 52.869565. We want to the nearest tenth. So I round that to 52.9. Well done! And now, the second part of the problem. Which of the following best describes the relationship between the computed mean and the actual mean? So if we look at our answer options here, the computed mean is either close or not close to the actual mean, and then the difference is being compared to 5%, so we're either more than 5% or less than 5%. So if I come back here to my calculator, clear that out, let's compute the actual difference so we know what we're looking at. 52.9 is the calculated or computed mean. 52.2 degrees listed here in the problem statement is the actual mean. So we're going to take the actual mean to 58.2, subtract out the computed mean, 52.9, this is 5.3, divide by the actual, 52.8, multiply by 100, and as you can see, we're at 9.1%, which is greater than that 5% threshold, so therefore, we're going to conclude that it's not close to the actual mean, because we're more than 5% off. Check our answer.
Nice work!
And that's how we do it at Aspire Mountain Academy. Be sure to leave your comments below. Let us know how good a job we did or how we can improve. And if your stats teacher is boring or just doesn't care to help you learn stats, go to AspireMountainAcademy.com where you can find out more about accessing our lecture videos or provide feedback on what you'd like to see. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.